Mariner Books and Harper Audio present The Best American Science Fiction and Fantasy 2021. Edited and with an introduction by Veronica Roth with John Joseph Adams, series editor. Performed by Veronica Roth, Joe Barrett, Tracy Lay, Christine Lakin, Sunila Nankani, Carly Roberts, Piper Goodeve, Alex McKenna, Priya Iyer, Ryan Vincent Anderson, Emily Ellett, Jennifer Sun Bell, Kong Sim, Aaron Bennett, Robin Eller, Jonathan Davis, Harvey Reeves, Alex Mraz, Maxwell Hamilton, Gustavo Rex, Adon Rocha, Katie Tang, Kif Vandenhoevel, Sterling Suleiman, Trey Hall, and Mayla Lee.
Foreword. Written by John Joseph Adams. Read by Joe Barrett. Welcome to Year 7 of the Best American Science Fiction and Fantasy. This volume presents the best science fiction and fantasy, science fiction fantasy short stories published during the 2020 calendar year, as selected by myself and guest editor Veronica Roth. About this year's guest editor. Veronica Roth burst onto the publishing scene in 2011 with her first novel, Divergent, which she famously wrote during her senior year at Northwestern University. That book went on to become a number one New York Times bestseller and a franchise-starting worldwide blockbuster. Divergent spawned two novel sequels, Insurgent and Allegiant, along with a story collection called Four. Collectively, the books have sold somewhere north of 40 million copies worldwide and were adapted into three major motion pictures. After the Divergent series concluded, Veronica returned with a new young adult duology, Carve the Mark and The Fates Divide, and then followed that up with a short story collection called The End and Other Beginnings. In 2020, Roth pivoted, making her adult debut with the novel Chosen Ones, which I was fortunate enough to acquire from my imprint at Houghton Mifflin Harcourt. It received high praise from previous BASFF series editors Diana Gabaldon and Charles Yu, not to mention the likes of Charlie Jane Enders, Blake Crouch, and Amber Benson, and also received a starred review from Kirkus Reviews, and despite coming out right when the pandemic started locking everything down, hit the New York Times bestseller list. Veronica's second adult novel is due out in 2022. Although Veronica began her career as a novelist, she's also passionate about short fiction. Above, I mentioned her short story collections, but it's worth noting that outside of those, she's also published stories and anthologies such as Summer Days and Summer Nights, Shards and Ashes, Wastelands, The New Apocalypse, and in the Amazon Original Stories Deconstructed Anthology, Foreword. Footnote. Amazon Original Stories has been publishing a series of projects over the last several years that they call collections, but which I always think of as deconstructed anthologies. They're clearly assembled as anthologies and feature short works by multiple authors, but the stories are all downloadable individually rather than together as a single book. Since collection is typically used to refer to a single author collection, a book of short stories that is comprised only of a single author's work, it seems imprecise to use that terminology for the Amazon Original Stories publications. I may be the only one who will ever call them deconstructed anthologies, but in my mind, that's clearly what they are. End footnote. Plus, in 2020, she also had a new story out called The Least of These in Lightspeed. While I was working with Veronica as her novel editor, one of the things that stuck in my mind was how when she went to WorldCon for the first time in 2019, she read every piece of short fiction on that year's and the previous year's Hugo ballot. I also learned that she was a huge fan of Frank Herbert's Dune and the works of Madeleine L'Engle and Philip K. Dick, and that she was likewise already a fan of several contemporary masters such as Nnedi Okorafor, Charlie Jane Anders, Ted Chiang, and Seanan McGuire, all authors who have either been reprinted in BASFF or had notable story selections. Once I factored all that in, the editorial calculus told me she'd make a very fine guest editor. And after you read the stories, I think you'll agree that my math has never been more right. Veronica, her husband Nelson, and her dog Avi live in Chicago, a city she deeply loves and deeply loves destroying. Selection criteria and process. The stories chosen for this anthology were originally published between January 1st, 2020 and December 31st, 2020. The technical criteria for consideration are 1. Original publication in a nationally distributed North American publication, that is, periodicals, collections, or anthologies in print, online, or ebook. 2. Publication in English by writers who are North American or who have made North America their home. 3. Publication as text. Audiobook, podcast, dramatized, interactive, and other forms of fiction are not considered. 4. Original publication as short fiction. Excerpts of novels are not knowingly considered. 5. Story length of 17,499 words or less. 6. At least loosely categorized as science fiction or fantasy. 7. Publication by someone other than the author, that is, self-published works are not eligible. And 8. Publication as an original work of the author, that is, not part of a media tie-in licensed fiction program. As series editor, I attempted to read everything I could find that meets the above selection criteria. After doing all of my reading, I created a list of what I felt were the top 80 stories, 40 science fiction and 40 fantasy, published in the genre. Those 80 stories, hereinafter referred to as the top 80, were sent to the guest editor, who read them and then chose the best 20, 10 science fiction, 10 fantasy, for inclusion in the anthology. The guest editor reads all of the stories anonymously, with no bylines attached to them, nor any information about where the story originally appeared. The guest editor's top 20 selections appear in this volume. The remaining 60 stories that did not make it into the anthology are listed in the back of this book as Other Notable Science Fiction and Fantasy Stories of 2020. 2020 Summation. In order to select the top 80 stories published in the science fiction fantasy genres in 2020, I considered several thousand stories from a wide array of anthologies, collections, and magazines. As per usual, because there is so much good material published in any given year, it was difficult to decide which stories were among the best, and so, outside of my top 80, I ended up with another 60 or so stories that were of similar high quality. The top 80 this year were drawn from 43 different publications, 26 periodicals, 13 anthologies, 2 single-author collections, and 1 standalone digital chapbook. The final table of contents draws from 17 different sources, 11 periodicals, 5 anthologies, and 1 single-author collection. Tor.com, the magazine of fantasy and science fiction, and Lightspeed are tied for the most selections, 2. Every other venue represented in the table of contents has 1 story each. Only 2 of the authors selected for this volume, Daryl Gregory and Ken Liu, previously appeared in BASFF. Thus, the remaining authors are appearing for the first time. This is the second appearance for both Gregory and Liu. 4 periodicals appear in BASFF for the first time this year. 3 of those are long-storied literary magazines, not particularly known for publishing genre works. The Paris Review, A Public Space, and One Story. The 4th periodical to join BASFF's ranks is Fantasy Magazine. A trailblazer in online fiction publishing that returned in 2020 after several years of hiatus. All of the above, save for Paris Review, were included in our top 80 for the first time this year, and joining them are Alta, Apparition Lit, Daily Science Fiction, and Drabblecast. Several authors were tied for the most stories in the top 80, with 2 each. A.T. Greenblatt, Alex E. Harrow, Charlie Jane Anders, K.T. Brisky, Ken Liu, Maurice Broaddus, Sophia Samatar, Stephen Graham Jones, Yahunka Delgado, with both being selected for inclusion, and Yoon-Ha Lee. Overall, 70 different authors are represented in the top 80. Sarah Pinsker's and Meg Ellison's stories selected for inclusion, Two Truths and a Lie and The Pill, were both named finalists for the Hugo, Locus, and Nebula Awards. Pinsker's story was the winner of the Nebula for Best Novelette and was also nominated for the Bram Stoker Award. Among the notable stories, there were three stories that were named finalists for the Hugo Award. The Mermaid Astronaut by Yoon-Ha Lee, Badass Moms in the Zombie Apocalypse by Ray Carson, and Burn, or The Episodic Life of Sam Wells as a Super by A.T. Greenblatt. All three were also finalists for the Locus Award. The latter two stories above were also finalists for the Nebula Award, as were the following notable stories. Stepsister by Leia Sipas, Advanced Word Problems in Portal Math by Amy Peachy, The 8,000ers by Jason Sanford, and Shadow Prisons by Carolyn M. Yoakum. In addition to the stories named above, the following notable stories were also Locus Award finalists. If You Take My Meaning by Charlie Jane Anders, A Whisper of Blue by Ken Liu, Fairy Tales for Robots by Sophia Samatar, The Sycamore and the Sibyl by Alex E. Harrow, and The Girlfriend's Guide to Gods by Maria Davana Headley. One story, The Bone Stag Walks by K.T. Briskey, was a finalist for the Aurora Award. Note, the final results of some of the awards mentioned above won't be known until after this text is locked for production, but will be known by the time the book is published. Anthologies. The following anthologies all had stories selected for inclusion in this year's volume. Burn the Ashes, edited by me, Hugh Howey, and Christy Yant, Volume 2 of the Dystopia Triptych. Take Us to a Better Place, Stories, presented by the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation. Made to Order, Robots and Revolution, edited by Jonathan Strawn. The Book of Dragons, edited by Jonathan Strawn. And Far Away, presented by Amazon Original Stories. Footnote. I have taken to using the phrasing presented by rather than edited by in situations such as this, where you have a book of short stories that is clearly an anthology, but it is published in such a way that does not credit an anthology editor. In some cases, such as this one, an organization is credited. Other times, there is only a publisher. End footnote. Several other anthologies had stories in the top 80. The other two volumes of the Dystopia Triptych, Ignorance is Strength and Or Else the Light, edited by me, Hugh Howey, and Christy Yant, Entanglements, edited by Sheila Williams, Escape Pod, the science fiction anthology, edited by Mer Lafferty and S.B. Divya, The Decameron Project, presented by the New York Times, Out of Line, presented by Amazon Original Stories, Psy Wars, edited by Joshua Viola, and Us in Flux, presented by the ASU Center for Science and the Imagination. The anthologies with the most stories in the top 80 were Made to Order, Robots and Revolution, 3, The Book of Dragons, 3, Or Else the Light, 2, and Take Us to a Better Place, Stories, 2. Plenty of anthologies published fine work in 2020, but just didn't end up with a story in the top 80. Here's a partial list. Breathe Fire, edited by Brant Lambert and Devon Sanders. Avatars, Inc., edited by Anne Vandermeer. Miscreations, Gods, Monstrosities, and Other Horrors, edited by Doug Marano and Michael Bailey. A Phoenix Must Burn, 16 Stories of Black Girl Magic, Resistance, and Hope, edited by Patrice Caldwell. The Dystopian States of America, edited by Matt Bechtel. Recognize Fascism, edited by Crystal Huff. Subterranean, Tales of Dark Fantasy 3, edited by William Schaefer. Glitter Plus Ashes, Queer Tales of a World That Wouldn't Die, edited by Dave Ring. Final Cuts, edited by Ellen Datlow. Evil in Technicolor, edited by Joe M. McDermott. Dominion, an anthology of speculative fiction from Africa and the African diaspora, edited by Zelda Knight, and Akpeki Ogunachowe Dunald. My Battery is Low and It is Getting Dark, edited by Patricia Bray and Joshua Pommetier. Galactic Stew, edited by David B. Coe and Joshua Pommetier. And Apocalyptic, edited by S.C. Butler and Joshua Pommetier. Collections. One collection had a story selected for inclusion this year, Big Girl by Meg Ellison. The only other collection represented in the top 80 was Nine Bar Blues by Cherie Renee Thomas. Here are some other notable collections that included excellent work in 2020. Some of these contained only reprints and thus had no eligible material, but I'm acknowledging them here anyway in order to shine a light on good works. Universal Love by Alexander Weinstein, Why Visit America by Matthew Baker, The Hidden Girl and Other Stories by Ken Liu, Velocities, Stories by Kathy Koja, Children of the Fang and Other Genealogies by John Langan, The Road to Whoop-Whoop by Eugene Bacon, The Best of Elizabeth Bear by Elizabeth Bear, The Best of Jeffrey Ford by Jeffrey Ford, If It Bleeds by Stephen King, The Post-Utopian Adventures of Darger and Surplus by Michael Swanwick, The Grand Tour by E. Catherine Tobler, and The Midnight Circus by Jane Yolen. Periodicals. More than 100 periodicals were considered throughout the year in my hunt for the top 80 stories. I read magazines both large and small, and sought out the genre stories that might have been lurking in the pages of a literary and/or mainstream periodical. The following magazines all had work representing them in the top 80 this year: Asimov's, 3, Clark's World, 3, Fireside, 2, Faya, 2, Future Tense, 2, Lightspeed, 7, The Magazine of Fantasy and Science Fiction, 6, Nightmare, 4, Strange Horizons, 2, Tor.com, 8, and Uncanny, 3. The following periodicals had one story each: Alta, Analog, Apex, Apparition Lit, Beneath Ceaseless Skies, Conjunctions, Daily Science Fiction, Drabblecast, Fairy Tale Review, Fantasy Magazine, Granta, One Story, Podcastle, The Paris Review, and A Public Space. The following magazines didn't have any material in the top 80 this year, but did publish stories that I had under serious consideration: The Adroit Journal, Bane.com, Cape Cod Poetry Review, The Dark, Escape Pod, Flash Fiction Online, Gargoyle, Kaleidotrope, Plowshares, Pseudopod, Terraform, and Weird Tales. Normally, this is where I'd issue some requiem for the magazines that have ceased publication in the past year, but despite all of the actual tragic deaths this year due to the pandemic, periodicals seem to have somehow thrived, or at least survived. In fact, I don't see any notable periodicals that folded in 2020, which is rather remarkable. And in fact, at least two top magazines returned from the dead: Apex and Fantasy. There were also a handful of promising new magazines announced I'll be keeping an eye on as they start publishing.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.